Recollections at 30. NBC, celebrating its 30th year of broadcasting, invites you to memorable moments of radio's earlier days. In this special series of broadcasts, you'll reminisce among NBC's vast and historic library of sound. You'll hear the stars, the songs, the great moments in sports and special events that have highlighted these 30 years of NBC network broadcasting.
Good evening, everyone. This is Fred Parsons, substituting tonight for your regular host, Ed Herlihy. With the use of NBC's vast library of sound, we're going to take a look at the dance music of the 30s. And those of us who were teenagers back then can silently ponder, were we much different from today's teenagers? Today, we're all aware that both the press and the public are greatly disturbed over the phenomenon called rock and roll. Where, we older people ask, is the sweet music of yesteryear? Now, if I remember correctly, our parents said the same thing to us back in the 30s. Let's take a listen to some of the music we danced to in the not-so-long ago. You recall the College of Musical Knowledge and that makes-you-want-to-dance man, Kay Kyser? Here he is from one of his 1938 broadcasts.
The class is now adjourned to the commons, where there will be intramural messing around. I declare a fee-fi-fo fumble. What I mean is dance.
Flatfoot Flugey with a Fly Fly. What a sweet, appealing title. Comparable, wouldn't you say, to rock and roll titles like Hound Dog and Blue Suede Shoes. And for further comparison, we'll turn to another number in swing jargon. Here is the way Glenn Miller himself introduced it to you in a 1939 broadcast from Carnegie Hall.
The girl, Marion Hutton.
Can't invent
please.
The audience you heard responding so wildly to that Glenn Miller arrangement was sitting, or rather jumping up and down, in the sedate confines of Carnegie Hall, where there was a concert that evening in commemoration of the 25th anniversary of ASCAP. I can remember that in those days, there was so much musical jargon that parents didn't know what their children were talking about. There was one radio show which tried to interpret the generation of jitterbugs to the bewildered older generation. Here's an excerpt from that show, which was called Inside Story.
Now the inside story of the jitterbug. Not so long ago, a boy and girl danced like this. But suddenly something happened. Today, the boy and girl danced like this. Something happened. A strange new race was born, and they even speak a strange new language. Tonight, two of these jitterbugs in person. They were captured in the wilds of a Chicago ballroom just after winning 70 jitterbug contests. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Margie Davern and Mr. Jack Gortz. Jack, as I understand it, a jitterbug is highly susceptible to a type of music called swing. And swing music can be defined as a sort of individualistic improvisation adapted from a basic melodic and rhythmic motive. Is that right?
No.
Well, if my version's wrong, what's the correct version?
Well, swing is a bunch of cats, strictly in the groove. They're swinging out and blowing their tops and sending themselves and all the hep cats and alligators right out of this world.
Well, I see. Well, couldn't you explain that a little more simply?
Seems simple to me. Go ahead, Sugar. See if you can straighten them out.
Okay, there's nothing to it. You see, after the cats get through licking their chaps and frisking their whiskers, they go into a gang, mugging light and heavy and kicking out. Do you get it now?
Well, now, maybe we'd better go at this piece by piece. In the first place, what is this thing you refer to as a cat?
That's a swing musician. He's not just a paper man, he's a cat.
Well, what does the cat do?
A cat ad-libs. He's strictly in the groove. He gets carried away and makes up his own licks.
Makes up his own licks?
Sure. He gets out with some notes of his own.
Yeah, I think I understand.
It's about time.
In other words, a cat or a swing musician becomes inspired by the music and adds some original ideas of his own.
I think Jack's explanation was better.
Yeah, all right, Margie. Do you jitterbugs have any preference among the dance bands?
Sure, Jack and I like a band that's strictly cat. Nothing on the cob or icky.
Nothing on the cob or icky? What does on the cob mean?
It's corny, razzmatazz stuff from 1920.
Old-fashioned ragtime, eh? And what about this word icky?
It's got too much schmaltz. It's too sweet. It's so sweet it practically drools. It's icky.
Oh, I'm learning fast. How long do you think it would take me to become a jitterbug?
Well, right now you're not even a greenfield.
A greenfield? What's that?
He's a beginner. He's green. He's just learning to become a gator.
A gator?
Yeah, an alligator. That's when you can really start to swing.
When you can really start to swing?
Yes, but you're still not a hep cat.
A hep cat?
Sure. A jitterbug that's hep to cats. He knows his onions about swing music and swing musicians.
What do you think of our orchestra, Roy Shield and his boys?
Let's hear the licorice stick.
Licorice stick?
Yes, the clarinet. That's swell. What do you say, Margie?
He's okay. Now let's hear the doghouse.
Yes, the old bass fiddle. That's swell. Give us a slipstick.
So, the slipstick is the trombone.
Yes. Come on, boys. Get hot. Well, listen to that. Those cats are licking their chops. How about it, sugar?
Yeah, man. Let's go to Daddy.
Jitterbugs, Marjorie Devon, and Jack Quartz for your inside story.
Yes, swing was the thing. And in those days, we applied it to old, well-known musical numbers, too. Here from Manhattan Merry-Go-Round is Milton Cross introducing one such.
Well, here it is, Dardanella, the tune you first heard in ragtime when Ted Lewis helped it on its way to fame 20 years ago. Since its early days, Dardanella has been played in jazz time, waltz time, and now in swing time. Arden and Arden bring you their own arrangement of this old favorite.
Be accurate to say that all the music of the 30s was swing or hipped-up versions of standard tunes. Bing Crosby was America's favorite singer, and good old relaxed Bing was saluting a dance that seems to be popular in every generation.
Let's walk for old time's sake, darling, before the heart you broke a break, darling, while light are low. Someone's waiting, I see, but didn't he take you from me? He'll never miss those few moments that it may take. Darling, let's walk for old time's sake. Didn't he take you from me? Why, he'll never miss those few moments that it may take. Darling, let's walk for
Crosby from one of his 1937 Music Hall broadcasts. And to demonstrate that even the great heroes of the swing era were genuine musicians who could render any sort of music most effectively, let's hear from Glenn Miller once again. This time, he's not noticeably swinging it, as we used to say. He is appealingly sentimental as he plays Danny Boy.
Danny
pretty wonderful, huh? But the truth is that in the 30s, swing was king. Swing was the thing. And, of course, the big swing band best known in every ice cream parlor and every dance hall and rumpus room across the whole country was the Benny Goodman Orchestra. In the NBC Library of Sound, I found what Benny Goodman and his band played on the night of that ASCAP concert previously mentioned. And I've hunted in some old record catalogs, and I can't find that he ever recorded this number, which I'm about to play for you. If anyone knows that I'm wrong, if anyone has a Goodman recording of this number, I'll be happy to stand corrected.
And now a little musical fun titled, "Tain't What You Do, It's the Way How You Do It." I've always wanted to sing in Carnegie Hall, and I think this is my chance. About 3:30, my dad said, "Son, come here to me. Things may come and things may go, but here's one thing that you ought to know.
Tain't what you do.
It's the way how you do it.
Tain't what you do.
It's the way how you do it.
Tain't what you do.
It's the way how you do it.
That's what gets me now.
Mama, mama.
Tain't what you do.
It's the way how you do it.
Tain't what you do.
It's the way how you do it.
Tain't what you do.
It's the way how you do it.
That's what gets me now.
Well, all right, man. Some voice, eh, kid?
Take it easy.
Breezy.
Bring you want to swing.
Well, swing them, boy.
Take what you say.
It's the way how you say it.
Take what you play.
It's the way how you play it.
Take what you can.
The way how you can.
Say, Benny.
Yeah.
What do you mean by K?
I mean Kay Kyser. He wouldn't play that song that way.
He wouldn't?
No.
Then how would he play it?
You ask the boys. They know. Student! Listen to the sassy trumpet. And now the shortest 15 minutes in radio, Fred Wayne. It taint what you... It's the way that you... That's what gets me so old. And now that sentimental gentleman of swing, Tommy Dorsey.
Tommy, on a night like this, Tommy, we go heading in the park, Tommy.
And now the sweetest music this side of heaven. Remember now, this is really all in fun now. This is really all in fun. Guy Lombardo. Oh, yeah.
Me
some of that Carnegie Hall jive, huh?
You take me, Kate.
Let's face it, after sampling the dance music of the 30s, do we have a good leg to stand on when we criticize today's rock and roll craze? We'd like to hear your opinions. Send them, together with any requests that you might have, to Ed Herlihy, care of NBC, 30 Rockefeller Plaza, New York City. Ed'll be back next week to play host for you more performances of radio's earlier days. Meanwhile, this is Fred Parsons wishing you good night.
Recollections at 30. Next week at this time, there'll be another in this special series commemorating NBC's 30th year of broadcasting. This is Fred Collins, hoping you'll be able to join us then for more of the great stars and great moments of the past. Recollections at 30 is directed by Bob Mauer. Recollections at 30 is another worldwide presentation of the United States Armed Forces Radio and Television Service.